Hello everyone, I hope you are doing good. In previous class we have discussed on cascade method, and Navin professor also put the video on various hydraulic circuits for different machine tool applications. I hope you all viewed that video of both of us, both me and Navin professor's video. So today's class we are going to look on electrical control for fluid power systems. So this is very basic fundamental components which we already know about, the electrical components used in hydraulic and pneumatic circuits. So in previous era they are used manual control. Now everything is in electrical control mode because of it can be easily controlled, its flexibility and accurate. For the purpose we are going with electrical control devices. So what are all the electrical control devices we are usually using is push button switches, solenoids, limit switches, relays, pressure switches, timers and temperature switches. These are all the things we know already. So just we look into what it is and what is the symbol for each electrical control devices. So first we look about push buttons. What does mean by push button? We already know that a simple push button, we have seen in many punching operations, a push button is a momentary switch. If you just press, then it starts to on. When it is released, then it starts to completely the circuit is braked. So this is push button switches are primarily used for starting and stopping of a machinery. It's a momentary operation. We have seen in electrical motor also. In electrical motor also, we simply on that motor we will simply use a push button to operate. So it has four types. What is single pole, single throw, single pole, single throw, the same thing, but it is varies with normally open and normally closed. Similarly, double pole, single throw, and double pole, double throw. So what it is? Actually, normally open means the button itself is normally open. This is a circuit line. Here the contact is braked. When you push it, then the circuit starts to actuate. So normally it is open. When you push, that electrical current passes through it. When it is not pushed, the circuit is in always in a open condition. In a for normally closed, that is normally closed, single pole, single throw is actually the circuit is closed. The current is always flows in that line. If you want to cut off the current, you just push, then automatically it just cut off the current. So it is normally open and it is normally closed. So double pole, double throw is switching over. If the current is going in a here we have double pole, now the current is flows in a pole number one. So if you want to switch over to the another pole, so it is normally open as well as normally closed. That is, here it is normally open and here it is normally closed. If you push it, then another circuit is get connected. So similarly, double pole, double throw means we have double pole here one pole and here one pole. That the same thing, here we have only single throw, but here we have here one throw we have and here another throw is also available. So at a momentary we can operate two throws, that is two electrical circuit lines is connected. So this is what the push button is mean for. Push button we already seen in many application, in real time application also we have seen such push button operations. The limit switches, next one is limit switches. So in cascade method we have discussed on limit switches. The limit switches are used to identify the extreme limits of the cylinder actuator. When the cylinder actuator extends or retracts, when the cylinder extends at the extreme point, the limit switches is got activated. And the same wise, when extreme condition of retraction stroke, that point also the limit switches starts to activate. So it is about to identify the extreme limits of extension and retraction of a cylinder. So push button is operated manually, whereas the limit switches are mechanically actuated by the extension of the cylinder itself. The cylinder actually hits that limit switch and limit switch start to operate. The symbol for limit switch is LS, that is limit switch not normally open and limit switch is normally closed. Usually the limit switch is closed here, here it is open. When the cylinder strikes, then the limit switch starts to close. Here when the limit switch is struck, then automatically the circuit is open. So this is what the difference between LS, that is limit switch normally open, limit switch is normally closed. So this is a cylinder where one limit switch is at retraction and another limit switch is used for extension. When it comes here, then this limit switch is operated. When it goes to the extension stroke at extreme point, this second limit switch is used. So there are many operators available, such as cams, levers, rollers and plunges to mechanically actuate the limit switch. So we can use the in order to actuate limit switches, we can use cams, which we have studied in kinematics, levers, rollers and plunges. So this is about the limit switches. Next we go with the pressure switches. We know that pressure switches are used to sense a change in pressure automatically. It measures the pressure. So when the pressure is exceeds or when the pressure is reduces at a defined point, that pressure switches automatically opens and closes. Here also we have two types. One is pressure switches normally open, pressure switches normally closes. Okay, so usually when the pressure is exceeds, the switch is activated and we connecting this line, the electrical line. Actually this electrical line is coupled with the solenoid valves, that is in order to energize solenoid we use such switches. So they have usually two pressure settings, namely high and low pressure. If you want a high pressure, we have to set a pressure. According to that pressure, the switches is actuated. We have to maintain a given pressure in the circuit. In a circuit, it may be required to stop a pump to maintain a given pressure, or start a pump for high pressure. So this is the setting for pressure switches. Then we have temperature switches. Temperature switches also a switches to sense the temperature automatically, electrically sensing the temperature, and it starts to open and close. Here also we have TS, temperature switches normally opens, temperature switches normally closes. Then we have solenoid valves. The solenoid valves is an electromagnetic transducer. So you know that what has been by transducer. So transducer is a device which converts electrical energy into reciprocating motion, that is mechanical force. The solenoid is electromagnetic mechanical transducer that converts the electrical signal into a mechanical output force. So the solenoid switches actually used to switching the direction control valves. So we have position 1 and position 2 in direction control valve. If you imagine what is meant by direction control valve, you can know about that. So it is used to switch over the things of direction control valve. Solenoid valve has an indicator lamp. The indicator lamp is used to indicate the solenoid valve's actuation. So if solenoid valve starts to energize, then automatically it starts to indicate the indicator lamp. So we can know about that the solenoid valve starts to actuate. So this is the purpose we have indicator lamp. Solenoids used to push or pull force remotely used to fluid power valves, that is direction control valves. So in order to actuate direction control valves, the solenoid valves are used. Okay, so with this video is complete. In another video we look about the relays. Thank you.